الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حينا الفلاح حينا الفلاح لا إله إلا الله
إن الحمد لله نحمده نستعينه ونستغفره ونسترشده نعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فهو المهتد ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمدا عبد الله ورسوله وصفيه وخليله خير رسول اجتباه أرسله بالهدى ودين الحق ليظهره على الدين كله ولو كره المشركون وبعد أيها الإخوة السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته حديث اليوم مازال my topic today it's still about the importance of الوقف I started this topic two weeks ago and I read a lot of topics, studies, books talking about the importance of al-waqf for the Muslim community. A lot of PhD studies, research in Saudi, Kuwait, Khalij, Maghrib, Algeria, Misr, Egypt, everywhere talking about the importance of al-waqf. Why it's so important? The importance that Sahaba gave to the waqf. What did the Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam, the sunnah that he created, what happened to the waqf after? The 1400 days of experience of al-waqf, the endowment. Because I read a lot, I did not summarize anything. I was almost astonished to see how far we are from the Islamic world or from the awqaf that exists today. It was so far that I read that in some places in Mecca al-Mukarramah, they have waqf, they call it waqf al-batikh, watermelon, for people of Mecca. So someone, he gave waqf for his entire life from his fortune just to feed the Mecca people or the Hajjaj from al-batikh, watermelon. This is his waqf. Waqf al-aghat, waqf of some people, they used to exist in the past and they still existing. And you see them wherever you go. They call them al-aghawat or al-aghat. And those are people who, most of their job, their life, is just to sacrifice their life to clean the masajid and take care of the masajid. They live in the masajid. And all their life, their children, that's all what they do. They have special waqf in Mecca called waqf al-aghat. Awqaf, which I never thought, they said, what his name, radiallahu anhu, Salah al-Din Ayyubi, in Qala'at Dimashq, he used to have waqf for the poor, for the mom who doesn't have enough to feed their children. So he has mizabin in Qala'at Dimashq. Mizab is like, you know, it's like a small river, a small tunnel in the both sides, right and left. One that's run halib, milk, and the other one, water with sugar. And so those man comes every day and pick or take from that water or that milk to feed their babies and children. Awqaf kathir, a lot of awqaf, a lot of, I mean, even I read about Ibn Khaldun in his Muqaddimah, he said that when he went to Dimashq, suddenly he saw someone, he has plate, and those are special plate, he was serving in the castle, and accidentally he dropped that plate and it was broken. So he started crying, because you know that his master will punish him. So someone saw him and said, you know, you don't have to worry. Just take those pieces, broken pieces, take them to Awqaf al-Suhun. There is waqf special for the broken plate. Just masha'a, just to take care of those people so they have nothing to worry about. When I was reading about Awqaf al-Talaba, Awqaf, al-Jami'at, Awqaf al-Azhar, alone has more than 60 faculties, and its base established only from the waqf. It gives freedom for Al-Azhar and his shuyukh and his teacher and Shaykh Al-Azhar and all the scholars. It gives them freedom to talk, to say the haqq, to say the truth before the government or the system took over Al-Azhar. And the first thing they did is to stop Al-Waqf. And at that time, there is no minister for, shu'un al-diniyah or for religious minister. There is no minister for social issues there, because the waqf was to do everything. The waqf was the source for the whole community, for the whole society. When I read about how is our waqf today compared to the Western awqaf endowment, lil asaf, unfortunately, we lost a lot. And they said, the scholar, most of that is because of the mass understanding today and the less education on the manabia. Amana of the ulama and the shuyukh and du'at, most of the scholars, they talk, or most of the mass of Muslim today, most of what they understand from the waqf is to have a waqf for a masajid. So they limited Al-Awqaf only for masajid. And most of our discussion is to build masajid and to take care of the masajid at the expense of other important things that used to exist and used to be the most important things in the community, society, for the Muslim community. Especially after the masajid was taken, or the system take over the masajid and they support the masajid, there's nothing left for the people. And the most important, Al-Waqf, they said, the scholar, Al-Waqf is to create a third party between the Al-Khas wal-Hukumi, between the private sector and the system itself to create another system, another party that can balance the things. You are not doing things for the sake of your fortune or your treasure or to become stronger, and it's not government or from the system, from the government, but it's to create another category that can take that balance. And they do the things for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because the Muslim, I read about a professor, he's a Jewish professor, Ishaq writer, he wrote a book especially about Nidham al-Waqf al-Islami. He talked about al-Waqf al-Islam and he was amazed and he said, this is the most important gift the Muslim gave it to the West. Nidham al-Waqf al-Islami. They give it to the West. The West, they increase it. They make it strong. They have an institution of endowment. Unfortunately, Muslim, we went back and we lost most of our awqaf. And all our awqaf is about and surrounding what? Al-Masajid. We limited the ibadah in Masajid, in Shaha'ir. We limited our ibadah in just a few things. Even though Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, لَن تَنَلُوا الْبِرَّ حَتَّى تُنْفِقُوا مِمَّا تُحِبُّونَ. You will not reach al-birr, the top of al-iman al-khayr, until you give from. And he said, وَفِي ذَلِكَ فَلْيَتَنَافَسِ الْمُتَنَافِسُونَ. It's open for everybody. And we read that most of our hadara al-islamiyya, Islamic civilization, was never built because of the system or khalifa or sultan. It was built because of that sector, the sector of al-awqaf. And al-awqaf is not someone rich who will pay for the rest. Or someone rich, he's always there to keep the balance. And al-awqaf is open. Everybody has to participate. Al-ghani, al-faqir, the poor and the rich, the mass and the educated, the scholar, the male and the female. And when you read about al-awqaf of Muslim females, you will be really amazed. It starts with Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha. She's Umm al-Mu'mineen. Education of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Aisha, the first waqf she did, she bought a house and she said, I will make this house waqf for Fulan and his children and for this family and his children, and when they are all exterminated, it will go back to awqaf al-Muslimin. Aisha radiallahu anha. And when she gave his awqaf, she was really amazed because everything she gave toward that waqf, she put a perfume on it. It's perfume. Her money has a smell of perfume for awqaf. And when they ask her why you are doing this, she said, because I know that it will stand first of all, it will go first of all to the hands of Allah, then to the faqir or the poor. She has a special kind of sadaqah, of awqaf, sadaqah jariyah. This is Ummuna Aisha radiallahu anha. And she was competing with her sister Asma radiallahu anha. They have different approach. They said, Asma, every time she collects something, she give it to the waqf. Aisha, she collected until she get a big sum or amount, and then she give the whole thing. And both are from Bayt al-Siddiq, radiallahu ta'ala anha. As-Siddiqa bint al-Siddiq. And who started this? Nabiyuna Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. After the first thing he did when he migrated to Qila, he built a masjid, waqf for Qila. Then he moved to Al-Madinah Al-Munawwarah, he built Masjid Al-Madinah Al-Munawwarah. Then after that, no masjid built after that. And then he opened Al-Mashariah, the project, for the Muslim to compete. You have a dozen, you have a lot of Mashariah projects that Muslims are in need. I have just recently, brothers, they came and they asked me, Sheikh, we want to build a masjid or musalla. I said, brother, why? Why more? How many people are attending your musalla? How many people? Check musallayat and masjid in Indianapolis. 15, we have 17 between masjid and musalla. Most of them are empty. Why spending more? Why giving more? Why building more? إِنَّمَا يَعْمُرُ مَسَاجِدَ اللَّهِ مَنْ آمَنَ بِاللَّهِ وَالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ. I mentioned this ayah in the last khutbah. What is the focus? What is the hikmah of building masajid? It's you and me. To be educated, to be a good follower to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, a commitment person. It's not building the walls. So the target is you and me. The target is the human being. To have high quality, a good quality, a good understanding. This is why we build a masajid. If you compare this, and they have a lot of brothers, I don't want to say it, but you know, they want to go to the Hajj for the 5th and the 6th and the 7th and the 8th. May Allah give them that opportunity. And Allah, they have a fortune, they have, may Allah increase their fortune. But my brother, if you collect those numbers, you and others who are making the Hajj for the 5th and the 6th and the 7th time, and you multiply it, you will see a huge fortune, a billions of dollars wasted, and you have other fara'id that needs to be filled up and taken care of. Why I said? Because we understood, or most of them, as they understand, you know, a sadaqah, a jariyah, only building masajid, taking care of a masajid, and tripling, and you know, al-hajj, and going back and forth, and staying within. And you can see this clearly when you have any kind of fundraising. Check and see what is the amount given for, let's say, Islamic education, or for the education, or for the research, or for the, or even for the clinical or medical clinic for Muslim, or for food pantry, or for a new convert, or, and check and compare that amount with the amount given for the masjid or to build the masjid. You will always find people giving a fortune to build the masjid, but it's rare to find the people who understand what are the priorities of Muslim today here living in the West. It's rare. And because most of those individuals, they think there is no sadaqah when you build a clinic, a medical clinic. There's no sadaqah. He doesn't see it as sadaqah. He doesn't see that when you graduate student, or when you give education, and you are raising a Muslim, a human being who believes in Allah, and he knows the truth, and he carries the truth in his heart. We have students who are preparing today PhDs, graduating from Antioch. You don't think that this is sadaqah jariyah for you? You don't think that you are investing in a capital called human being? You are raising a Muslim, a mu'min, who fear Allah and know the truth and support the truth, and he will bring others with him. This is the real investment today. Male and female, because those, they will have children, they will have a families. And based on those families, our masajid in the future will have i'mar. إِنَّمَا يَعْمُرُ مَسَاجِدَ اللَّهِ مَنْ آمَنَ بِاللَّهِ وَالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ. It's those people who will support the masajid and will support the institution, and they will increase the numbers or the quality of Islam in this land. This is the real investment. I was reading about universities, and I was astonished because it's depend or it's based on the endowment of the university. The stronger this university is, I was checking numbers, it's when I checked Harvard, $28 billion each year. Bill or Yale, $18 billion. Jena Stanford, 14. Texas, 13. Massachusetts, MIT, $8 billion. Columbia, and you go down, then Michigan, then more, the endowment is strong, and all those measures, there are more than 1,600 universities in USA based on endowment. That's it. It's all about endowment. Because most of those people understood the importance of education in this country. And how to be, you know, independent, and have your own way of seeing the things, they know the importance of it. And this same thing happened in the past, you know, Adam Mead, he was talking about you know, the 4th century, which they call it Asr al-Nahda, or the age, the golden age of the Muslim. And he was talking about the importance of al-waqf for starting from the, you know, the Asr al-Nabawi, then Asr al-Rashidi, then Bani Umayyah, then Bani al-Abbas, then al-Sarjuqi, then al-Zanki, then al-Ayyubiyyin, until the end of al-Uthmaniyyin. And he was bringing numbers, and it was amazed how the Muslim took care of those awqaf. This is why he said that, you know, the heart, the essence, the moral, and the energy of Islam, it's in its awqaf. If you want to kill Islam, kill its awqaf. You have no endowment, and wait for the system to give you sadaqat, so you can survive. I was reading about Ibn Khaldun. He was talking about, you know, peoples, that are the people are three categories. There are people who, you know, they take and they don't give. They always ask for their right, but they never fulfill their duty. they always benefit and take advantage of the system, them and their children and their families, and but they never give back to whom, to what they receive from those ancestors. This is one of category of human being. There are other categories he mentioned, and he said that those people are neutral. They don't take and they don't give. They are neutral, they are negative, they don't help and they don't hurt. He said there are other categories, they give more than what they receive. And they participate more than what they claim or they want or they take advantage of the system. He said most of the Islam or the Islamic movement, it's based on the shoulder of those individuals who feel responsibility. Al-awqaf is all about feeling about the other. This is what is al-awqaf. You feel about the poor. You feel about the needy. You feel that ibadatullah ta'ala, if you want to worship Allah, is not just building a masjid. If you want to worship Allah, you have to feel what Allah created. And you feel their pain. And you feel their hunger. And you feel their need. This is what is ibadatullah. Aqrabukum ila Allah, aqrabukum aw khidmatan li'iyalih. The most close of you to Allah are the people who are close to those or filling the gaps of those needy. And those gaps which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we like it or not, but He made the right of al-fuqara in the duty or of al-aghniya. It's your duty. If you have any problem in this community, you will be asked first in front of Allah before He will ask someone from Algeria for those needy. And he was explaining that, this is what is all awqaf. It's all about niyyah. It's all about وَفِي ذَلِكَ فَلْيَتَنَافَسِ الْمُتَنَافِسُونَ. Muslimun, when they started awqaf, it was not to increase or not to take advantage, or let's say, it was not to get something from the tax back. Okay, I will take out your taxes and you will give for, and this is what they did here in the system. It was khalisatan for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And it was something that everybody need to participate. It's not for the rich or for a certain category or for the doctors or everybody has to participate. It's a come because everybody has to feel al-mujtama or the society, the community that he belongs. That belonging is so important. With the belonging we can take over or we can have a stability so the poor will not curse the rich. And they will not envy them. And then when they see them with whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave them, they will not talk or they have something in their heart because you are creating a balance in your community. But when you see that huge difference, and I'm talking about the Islamic community, how we should feel, how we should react, how we should, that balance is so important by cause of the awqaf. I heard a lot about al-awqaf until I was amazed, and I feel really that, there is a lot of shortcoming from even the du'at on the manabir, and the muhaf, and the muthaqafin, the educated people, and those who have enough knowledge to talk, because most of us, we completely neglect this sunnah, and this is sunnah nabawiyah, and most of the scholars, they made it farida ijtima'iyah. It's farida for every community to take care of their needs. It's farida ijtima. It started with the Nabi, then Nabi Hassan legislated clearly with Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu, when he went to Nabi and he told him, Ya Rasulullah, I get the best land of my entire life from Khaybar. Ya Rasulullah, it's so beautiful, advise me what to do with. He said, Ya Umar, sabbil aslaha or awqif aslaha wa sabbil far'aha. Ya Umar, endow the capital and let the benefit or the fruits be given for all the Muslims. Then Umar, he wrote that constitution or bylaws and he said it will never be inherited, never be sold or given or and it will be waqf for the Muslim. And then after Umar, all the Sahaba try or they compete, and until Abdullah ibn Jabir said, I don't know any Sahabi from the Sahaba of Rasulullah who didn't have an endowment. I don't know any Sahabi who can afford. Even the poor of the Sahaba, they give whatever they can, and they left endowment, awqaf, for their children and their families, and the poor and the needy, and for that. All the Sahaba, most of Azwaj al-Nabi has awqaf. And Nabi Hassan, he left his awqaf for the Muslim. This is how it started. It's all about awqaf. It's how Nabi Asana and all of them, all what we have, only one masjid. Masjid al-Nubuwa in Medina al-Munawwara. Only one masjid. وَفِي ذَلِكَ فَلْيَتَنَافَسِ الْمُتَنَافِسُونَ. If we are still thinking that building a masjid, even though we have enough money, is more important عند الله تعالى than have a clinic, medical clinic, or a research center, or education, or scholarship, or supporting school, or building awqaf for the school. If you think, still thinking, so there is a problem in our priorities. There is really a problem. أسأل الله تعالى أن يعلمنا ويزيدنا علما وعلما وتقبلنا. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وآله وصحبه وله. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري وحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. وبعد, my dear brothers and sisters, I will inshallah ta'ala talk in the future, in the next Jumu'at, about what the fuqaha, what they mentioned, what they talk, how they built that, you know, waqf. I will give you some experience, some numbers of what they are doing today. In a lot of Muslim lands, Saudi on top, Kuwait, Khalij, Egypt, Damascus, the way they are building that awqaf. And you will see that we have no alternative to survive, really, to fit and to compete here in the West, if we don't bring that experience that started 1400 years. Until now, people still drinking from bitter rumor that Uthman ibn Affan radiallahu ta'ala anhu offered for the Muslim as sadaqa jariyah. Until today. If you go to Medina al-Munawwara, you will find a place, there is a bustan, ha'at, a garden, there is a building, and that bitter, that well still until today, 1400 years. How many people drink from that water? Bitter rumor. Uthman ibn Affan radiallahu ta'ala anhu. It's the same thing. How many people will graduate from the school and they will have a higher diploma and they become, you know, they invest in that cycle. And you don't know how many people will come from that resort, from that, those people. How many people will be guided and they embrace Islam just because of your sadaqah jari or your endowments. We have four types of sadaqah. We have zakat, that is fard. And we have sadaqa al-jariya, that is munqati'a. You give it, he take it, and that's it. And you have the endowment or al-waqf in your life. And you have al-waqf after you pass away, which is called al-wasiyah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala opened for the Muslim, for the four ways for them to get imarat al-dunya wa imarat al-akhirah, to build your imara in this dunya and to get the benefit of your akhirah. My dear brothers and sisters, I don't want to take longer because today we have the intention to start a waqf, not sadaqa jariya, a waqf for our education, for the Islamic school. I'm not asking people to give huge amount of money, but I'm asking everybody to have a share in this waqf. A waqf that will not be given for people, a waqf that we will invest. We have, alhamdulillah, mashallah, we have some or few institutions in USA who are doing well, mashallah, investing that money, and it goes back with a lot of khayr to the schools, to the masjid. We need to start something like that in Indianapolis. The most important is